Hello beautiful people, if you're new here, my name is Tatiana and in today's video we will be talking about the types of looks modeling agencies are looking for, or how should the perfect model look in general. First of all, let me tell you, when the agency's bookers, the agency staff checking out their emails and seeing the applications from new people, they are not expecting to see anything particular. They're not even expecting to see some perfect beauty. Usually they're just looking for someone interesting with a nice personality, so the clients would be interested in those models in the future in some way. Despite that fact, it's common to highlight several types of looks modeling agencies are most interested in to understand how this whole business works and what exactly different fashion markets are looking for. So let's talk about each of these looks in details, and we will start with the edgy and strong features, or it also called strong faces. These models, these types of looks are usually highly requested on every fashion market. If you don't know what fashion markets or modeling markets are, you can check out my other video where I'm explaining everything in details. And usually they're highly requested on primary markets, which means that they will most likely have a very successful career. Usually these models are very tall and skinny, and they can be also very toned and a little bit sporty. In general, it's a great look for the modeling career. And now I'm going to show you some photo examples of these looks. More of them you can find on my Pinterest board. The link will be in the description box down below. And also all of the credits can be found there as well. Great example of strong look is Natasha Polly. As you can see, she has a strong cheekbones and her face is quite angular, and she looks really amazing both on the runway and in editorial shots. One more beautiful example is Lina Zhang. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. If not, I apologize. She looks gorgeous and confident and strong. One more model with a strong type of look is Alla Kostromicheva. And again, you can see a very strong cheekbones and face expression. Same with Julian. And of course, Coco Rocha. She's a very famous model. I'm sure you've heard about her if you're interested in fashion. She also has a strong type of look. Next type of look in modeling industry is commercial. Commercial looking models are usually very beautiful, very pretty, and this kind of beauty is understandable by everyone, not only the people who works in fashion industry. Commercial looking models are very successful on secondary markets, for example in Asian countries, and also they can work in every market as well, because advertising works and lookbooks and catalogs are shot in every market in every country. And comparing to the models with the strong and edgy features, the body of commercial looking models can be a little bit more feminine, but still they have to fit into modeling industry standards. If you want to know more about it, please check out my video. The perfect example of commercial look is Emily Di Donato, and she's absolutely amazing. I'm sure everyone thinks that she looks really beautiful and angel-like, just gorgeous beauty. Elsa Hosk is also a great example of commercial type of look. Blonde hair, blue eyes, and perfect body. If talking about plus size models, Ashley Graham has also a commercial look. She's really beautiful and she looks really amazing. few more examples, Stella Maxwell and Taylor Hill, and also Irina Shayk. Next type of look is classique. It's a little bit similar to commercial looking models, but still it's different because it's not that sweet and too pretty beauty. It's more like a beauty that can be understandable in every era, in every century. It's a classic beauty. These models are also sometimes called the blank canvas. I don't know if there's such expression in English language, but in Russian there is one, and it means that they can be transformed into almost anything. Their look can be changed depending on the makeup and hairstyle and styling. So they're like a universal models, and they highly requested on primary markets and in every market, but they're more popular in primary markets. I would say that they're not so often being booked in Asian markets. Here are a few examples of classic look. As you can see, these girls are quite neutral looking. Of course, they look beautiful and gorgeous, but what I'm trying to say is with certain makeup and hairstyle, they can be transformed into anything. The stylist can create any type of look. Next type of look is strange or alien beauty. It's a weird and unique beauty, and all of the modeling agencies are looking for new faces with these features because it's the future stars and future top models. The fashion designers getting inspired by such looks. They don't have to be pretty, and most of the times they aren't that beautiful in the eyes of the majority of people, but they are really interesting, they're eye-catching, and they're just amazing. I don't know how to explain it, but when you see this person, you just feel it. It's like a third sense, and you know that this new face will be a future star. Yes, strange-looking models are highly requested everywhere, so they usually mostly work in primary markets and get booked directly for some certain jobs. Strange looking models also often get exclusive contracts and work with one designer for a limited amount of time, and are very popular in general. If they plan their career correctly, if they have a nice modeling agency, they will work for a really long time and will be really successful. It's always interesting to see the examples of strange faces, and one of them is Kelly Mittendorf. She looks really wonderful, but her beauty not always can be understood by everyone. Also, models with a pale, light skin, light hair, and red hair can be described as strange looking. One more perfect example of strange look is Winnie Harlow. As you know, she has vitiligo, but still she looks really gorgeous. I think I would even say that she's not only strange looking, but also a little bit commercial, in my opinion, because her beauty is undeniable and she has a really beautiful face and body, and I would say that she's somewhere in the middle between the strange and commercial looking model. Lisa is one more example of strange look. The next type of look is baby faces. They are very cute, doll-like looking pretty models, and they are very popular in Asian market. Usually it's a very young model starting from 13 or 14 years old, and if they have a baby face, they can work for a really long time because mostly they will look really, really young even in their 30s. The great example is Natalia Vodianova, and the interesting fact is the baby faces don't have to be that tall, because in Asian market it's okay to work even if you're like 170 or 72 centimeters. Gemma Ward is a nice example of baby face. As you can see, she has this angelic look, doll-like features, blue eyes and light hair, light skin. Mika is also a doll-like, really cute, beautiful model. And I don't think that everyone can be described as only one category of looks. Most of the people can be described as a mix of these looks, and the great example is Devon Aoki. In my opinion, she looks both strange and has baby face. Lindsay Vixen also has kind of a strange features and baby face features. There are pros and cons in each look, and there are also some exceptions. Your modeling agency should educate you and plan your career based on how you look. And if you're working freelance or planning to work freelance and thinking about modeling career, I suggest you to do your research to analyze your look, and based on that choose a fashion market that will be more suitable for you. This way you will find your clients and will be the most successful in what you are doing. And I wish you good luck, and I will see you in my next videos. Bye.